for sure, the Sapphire of Ishua did not work, as no one came back from the dead. Just a delusional, psychotic state affecting the Plutonian, whom is in denial and refused to accept the impossibilities or admit failure. His deniability caused him to have a mental breakdown, which might be due to guilt of not being able to bring back those whom died by his hands. In his delirious state of mind, he was captured and subjugated by the Vespan soldiers. Then they encased and bound him with a clone straitjacket carved from his skin, for the Plutonian is no ordinary being. So the Vespan soldiers, true to their words, as beings of honor, did not make any attempt to take over Earth. For if you look at it and draw a conclusive approach, them having the Plutonian as their prisoner and subject, plus no thanks to pious Hornet, had made their job easy by giving them coordinates of Earth-like planets, especially defenseless ones. So the Vespa soldiers did something more honorable by interjecting into the left temporal lobes of the people of Earth by informing them that the Plutonian had been captured and become their prisoner. For this gives them the right to do whatsoever they want with him, and they can live in peace without his terror. It was a joyous moment on Earth. For the first time, the people had something to celebrate. The happiness they felt was uncontrollable. Our hero survivor was so overwhelmed with joy, he couldn't contain himself as he grabbed Kaidan and kissed her again. It didn't bother her, for she too was extremely happy, thanks to her for helping in the capturing of the Plutonian. Everyone was happy except Priggish Cubit, whom is very hard to impress. In captivity, the Plutonian is still in a fog state, believing he had brought back those that had died at his hands, also bringing back things to normalcy with the power evolving from the Sapphire of Ishua. Well, right here on Earth, our hero survivor couldn't wait to go on national TV to once again announce to the world, even though the Vespa soldiers just told everyone that the Plutonian had been captured and that he was never coming back. Without discussing it with anyone, placing himself in the position of authority, declared this day a public holiday, and in some way he was trying to take glory for the victory, when in truth it was the powers of Kaidan that facilitated the capturing of the Plutonian. To be frank and to be honest, he was getting boring. After emphatically pouring adulation on himself, he remembered his brother Syla and called him out that he believes he is still alive, as Kaidan couldn't invoke his spirit, while at the same time a comatose Syla woke up in the presence of Modius Android, which is being inhabited by Modius. Still going on and on in a garrulous manner, our self-appointed president, leader, and hero of the world, survivor, called out those heroes with special powers to come out of hiding, for the Plutonian was no more, and they can come together and build a better society, a new world. Well, he didn't stop there. He continued by stretching a hand of friendship to villains and outlaws with special powers to come out forward and help in the building of this new world that may also result to amnesty by forgiving all their past crimes, and that they should all put their differences aside, in which Cubit thought he was overreaching and being over the top, warning him not to promise more than he can handle. But our president, leader, and hero survivor ignored Cubit and continued in his speech by promising to do more than what the Plutonian did. In fact, he was sounding like he was in authority. It was unbelievable. Now, the Vespan soldiers were very cautious in handling the Plutonian, for they understood his capabilities and they were not taking any chances. When the Plutonian went into a state of psychosis, the Vespa soldiers encouraged his delusion by dampening his state of mind. But when they tried to bring him to consciousness, he refused to come back to his senses or reality, for he locked himself in the walls of his unconscious state, which bewildered the Vespa soldiers. Not knowing what to do with him, they threw him into a dungeon filled with alien mercenaries captured by the Vespa soldiers. In seeing the Plutonian, without giving him a breathing space, they attacked and beat the living daylights out of him. I mean, it was brutal. But the Plutonian wasn't responsive, for he was still locked up in the walls of his unconscious state.